Faces. so many smiling faces and so many people being familiar to me. While I was at Ronald McDonald House, I didn't have really any visitors.
Hi.
So the staff and everyone at Ronald McDonald House kind of came. Like my family too. A lot of times when you have a child with special needs, like for if I were appointed, if I was actually working at Cal, I would have that. But I'm everyone at the house, I mean, I really feel like this is my family. And we would talk all the time. I felt like that, like I said, an extended, like a sister or someone that was there, just to talk to me and be kind. And Kathy was always there. And like I said, Heather was there. And even like, I remember, it was two hospitality ladies, the ones who sing all the time in the hallways, or come. And that was always good to see her humming and singing, and kind of kept my spirits up too, even on those days. And it was kind of, would be kind of bad. And also the volunteers that would come and bring dinners, the different groups that was always requested to come and have a home cooked meal. And even the time the volunteers would come and we could have actually a home cooked meal there and just be able to sit and have family time. Those are the kind of things that are important when you are dealing with something that when you're kind of away from home and your child is in the situation. Really, you can't do anything about it but pray. And that's what I did. And Ronald McDonald allowed me to be able to be with, allowed me to be with my family at times, allowed me to be with my son every day. I was with Isaiah every day. I only went back to Greensboro twice in that time, and I was kind of having like an anxiety issue because I wanted to get back so bad to be there with him, and they provided that for me, and like I said, it just felt like home, and that's why it's important, to keep y'all smiles and continue to be friendly, because those are the things that we need, to smile, even if you don't have a lot to say or, I just